Advantages of balanced mutual fund schemes. Of late, interest rates on bank FDs have been falling. For a person who had invested 50 lakhs into bank FDs and was earning 4 lakhs per annum till last year, will now be having 3 lakhs as return. Upon that, after taxes, his net return is going to be 2 lakhs per annum, whereas his or her expenses have always been on the rise. There have been instances of people writing to the Prime Minister asking him to explain how to manage their expenses when returns are going down. So, FD investors are in for a very big challenge of facing lower and lower returns. Real estate has become unattractive as it has its own problems of liquidity and government regulations. Gold has lost its shine. It has been flat for several years. So people taking gold as investment is going down. So is there a solution for this lower rate regime now? Yes, balanced funds can be one of the options as a solution. When I say funds, there will be an immediate question coming into the mind. Wait, aren't mutual funds risky? Yes, mutual funds are risky, while balanced funds have some kind of a protection to the risk. Well, when we talk about bank FDs, is it safe as we think that it is? No, it is not. Banks lend to smaller companies and corporates when due diligence in their lending is not up to the mark. We will face defaults like what we had in Kingfisher and Deccan Chronicle. We will see more such cases in the coming months. Public sector banks are presently having 8 lakh crores of NPAs, and most of these NPA loans are given from the deposits that you and I have had in the banks. Most of these NPAs are now in the write-off stages. How these banks are going to face such a huge loss? Many banks are presently running NPAs that is more than their net worth. In that case, they should have to default on their deposits. It will be a huge surprise for us, because we didn't have a slightest inclination in our thoughts that bank FDs will get defaulted. Are we able to see the kind of risk that bank FDs are carrying? They are not safe as the way we thought it has to be. In the same manner, if we have to look at balanced funds and the risk that they carry, balanced funds invest 35% of their capital into debt, which is kind of a protection that they give to the capital. The balance 65%, of course, is in equity, and that carries risk. So carrying such kind of a risk, how these balanced funds have performed in the last 22 years of their existence? Maybe this thought or facts could help us get more clarity on why money is being pouring into balanced funds now. Let's look at the 5 top advantages balanced funds are having today. The first one is balanced funds are giving 10.6% average returns for a 10-year rolling period. And this is 2.5 times more than the bank FD rates which are presently available. And when I say 10-year rolling returns, it means that if you had invested into a balanced fund at any time in the last 22 years and have stayed invested for 10 years, your return is 10.6% average. The second advantage is the tax-free status. When somebody invests into balanced funds and that investment crosses 365 days, all the profits made in balanced fund is tax-free. The third one is the protection that these funds give when the markets are overvalued. When the markets get overvalued, they get out of equity exposure or reduce the equity exposure by booking profits, thereby protecting capital as well as the profits. The fourth one, the debt exposure of balanced funds helps the fund to keep growing even when the markets are going down. And the fifth and the only advantage, or the advantage that is attracting so much money into the balanced funds, is that these balanced funds are giving monthly dividends, which is committed dividends paid out at 10% per annum, which you can take it as a support for your expenses or monthly expenses. the present situation of money flows into mutual funds are, out of 125 lakh crores of FDs that are there in our country, 7 lakh crores have already moved to mutual funds, and it is expected that by 2020, another 70 lakh crore is going to come to mutual funds. So this asset or balance fund is one category which has a very high potential compared to bank FDs on return side. So you can take advantage of this and help your savings have very good returns. Thank you.